Halleluja.
Thank you for the privilege. I'm just seeing Apostle Tonya for the first time physically. Thank you. Your wife came to receive me, and she served me. I was shy yesterday. Thank you so much, Mommy. May the Lord add blessings to the proceedings of this meeting in the name of Jesus. And so, Lord, we ask that you help us. Cause your face to shine upon us and be gracious unto us. Take over the entire atmosphere. Go past the limits of our unbelief and let your sovereignty take over the affairs of this moment. By all means, grant that the men and women in our midst, that you order their feet to be part of this meeting because of the plans that you have to implement. Let such men be caught up with the fires of mercy. Amen. In so much that you will clothe them. Amen. You will empower them. Amen. And you set them in motion in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Now you may be seated. I'm not seeing where the keyboard. All right, you know, wait. Don't think you know what I want. Don't assume. In 25 minutes from now, you play softly on strings, okay? All right, let's turn our Bible quickly to the book of Psalms chapter 8. Psalms chapter 8. Psalms chapter 8 will begin from verse number 1. The Bible says, O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings hast thou ordained strength because of thy enemies, that thou mightest steal the enemy and the avenger. When I consider thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. For thou madest, thou hast put all things under his feet. I think we'll stop there for now. The first thing that overtook the meditations, the contemplations of the psalmist in this presentation is the wonder of creation. So he begins from a very broad context. Please stay with me. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. My voice is not normally loud, so you need to focus. Maybe when some fire comes, it will be louder. So the object of his contemplation was the diversity that was in the physical creation. And part of the things that motivated his interest is the delicate balance upon which the physical creation is established. The physical creation runs on a proceeding of cycles and cycles. So we have the nitrogen cycle, we have the oxygen cycle. That's how he sustains the physical creation, and it exists on a balance that is delicate. The delicacy of the balance that needs to be struck at every point in time in order for the physical creation to continue is so critical that you would think that God's ultimate attention is obviously preoccupied by the dynamics of the creation and how to sustain the balance that will keep it in a perpetual state of continuum. The psalmist rather said it is not the balances in the physical creation that is the emphasis of God. God is actually preoccupied by a certain creature called man. Now, you see, in the book of Psalms 8, verse 4, I consulted theological sources to find out the major context, the basic context of that verse. Most of the scholars say Psalms 8 verse 4 is an angelic debate. Angels came to God and began to ask God questions. The first question is, what is man? Are you with me? Because they noticed that God was not mindful of the vast islands of creation to establish the balances that will keep it continue. But God was mindful of the creature called man, so they had to come to God with a question. What is man? Not who is man. I know if I ask you, who are you? You will probably say your name. But if I ask you, what are you? You will need to consult with your manufacturer to know your essence, to know your relevance, to understand your ordination. So what is man is a deeper question than who is man. The reason for which the question was justified was that the angels were able to decode that God was mindful of him. That means God's mind was full of the creature called man. That's one. The reason why that question is justified is because God has a schedule that he has put in place, a calendar by which he visits every man. Because the Bible says, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest. You will notice that in the Garden of Eden, in the tight schedules of God, God still had a moment where he comes into the garden in the cool of the day to visit with Adam. And it will interest you to know that for every living human being, born again or not, God has a schedule of visitation for each and every one of us. So the angels were somehow perplexed. And they said, if you are going giving so much attention to humankind, it means they have a meaning, they have a relevance, they have a significance in your agenda that we do not yet understand. So can you educate us further so that we can have a renewed understanding of who this creature is? What is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? Are you with me? That's not the end of the presentation. They went further to say, for thou, next verse. Okay, for thou hast made him a little lower than the angels. You have to stop there. Let's go to sometimes in order for us to understand the import of several verses in the Bible. We will need to launch a linguistic investigation to go into the original languages to unpack the actual meanings of the words that were used, such meanings that were lost when translations to English language occurred. Hallelujah. Now, sister, what's your name? Yeah. Don't stand up. Just answer. Lillian. What's your dialect? What's the name of your dialect? Your local dialect. Okay. Now, what's the name for stubborn in your language? You don't know. My brother, what's your name? No, you don't need to stand up. Friday. So what's your local dialect? What's the name of your dialect? Anan, from Akwa Ibom. What is stubborn in that language? Give him a microphone. So that other people that are from your tribe can either confirm or reject what you are saying. Stubborn.
Ntrutong.
Any confirmation there? Yes. That means it's on course. Now, we have not finished. Now, there are two things. There is translation. And then there is transliteration. To transliterate means to say the word flat, the way it is, not the meaning that it is pointing to. So if you transliterate what you said, what does it transliterate to?
Song Ibu.
Wait. I know you don't understand what I mean. In my own language, the transliteral meaning of stubborn in my language is strong leg. So what's the transliteral meaning of that thing you said in Anan language?
Strong head.
Now,
strong here.
You see,
strong here.
Okay, let's assume that you are saying the right thing. Do you mean strong ear or strong head? Strong ear. Do you know the meaning of what you just did now? It means that in Anan language, there is no word for stubborn. No single word for stubborn. It means English language is deeper than Anan language. If you are translating from English to Anan, some meanings will be lost in the process. But I'm saying, are you there with me?
Yes.
Stay with me. I'm saying that Greek language is deeper than English language. So when you are translating from Greek to English, meanings will be lost because Greek is deeper. If Hebrew language is deeper than English language, when you are translating from Hebrew to English, meanings will be lost. So many significant meanings will be lost because Hebrew language is even deeper than Greek language. So once in a while, we will need to launch linguistic investigations to scripture in order for us to recover the meanings that were lost through translation. Do you understand me now? Good. So let us do an analysis. If you came here with a Bible that is equipped with a lexicon, click on angels. when you click on angels, the word angels in this scripture. You are not following me. The objective of our effort is to investigate that question and to answer it. And the question is, what is man that thou art mindful of him? Any answer that we are going to give must fit into the original context of Psalms 8 verse 4. If we get one meaning and we fix it into that scripture, that meaning must be a sufficient meaning that makes man, God, mindful of man, and that makes God visit man. Are you with me? If we get the second meaning must pass the test of context. Are you with me? You are not following me. You see, the purpose of this conference is deep. We cannot be shallow and access the purpose of the conference. We will need to travel. We will need to migrate. And I'm taking it easy so that you can follow. Are you there? When you click on the word angels in that scripture, for thou has made him a little lower than the angels. If you click on the word angels in that scripture, if your Bible is electronic and it is equipped with a lexicon, you will find the word there is Elohim. Are you with me? If you find that word in Hebrew called I am, are you there? Elohim, Anakim, Cherubim, Emim, Zamzuzim. All these words that you have, I am, are in plural. The singular for cherubim is cherub. The singular for Anakim is Anak, sons of Anak. You there? So when we say Elohim, we are referring to the quadrant of the Godhead when the three persons of that system are involved. You will realize that redemption was an effort of Elohim. The reason why it took the three members of the Godhead to achieve redemption is because during creation, when God wanted to create man, it was an effort of Elohim. He says, let us. Is that what is in your Bible?
Yes.
Make man in our own image. In fact, the Bible did not say that man was to be created. The Bible said man was to be made. There are three processes that are involved in the making of man. Unfortunately, the third aspect of the process was not concluded before man fell. So the first man that was created in the idea of what God had in mind for coming up with the policy, let us make man. The first man after that order was Jesus Christ, when he came for John the Baptist's baptismal service. And what happened to him when he came out of the water was accreditation. Heaven was saying, this is the idea that we had in mind when we set out to make man. You are not following me. You see, I'm taking it easy because you can't climb if you don't have insight. And you cannot participate effectively in spiritual warfare if you have no spiritual knowledge. So stay with me, let's climb. Can we climb?
Yes,
so, the Bible says, for thou hast made him a little lower than Elohim. The word Elohim is the name for God in the context of his Godhead. Are you still with me?
Yes,
you are not following. How I wish I had a board. I would have shown you that the object of verse 5 is an organogram. The organogram of the universe. In terms of rank, in terms of hierarchy, in terms of stature, it is a clue about the organogram of the universe. Now let us draw a map, maybe a chart on your jotter, to explain this organogram before I continue in the process. But the object of my teaching is that we need to answer the question that the angels are asking. If we can answer that question, then we can now define what a mantle is. If we cannot answer that question, it will be impossible to define what a mantle is. Are you still with me? Now, if you came with a jotter, draw a chart like this. Then you put on one side invincible. You put on another side visible. I'm still checking you whether you are really ready for this service. I'm still checking. If I find out that you are ready, then we'll go deeper. You know, sir, you know, I go to minister in some places, I see the people. What they want is, they want an event. All right, so we do an event. We can even get the keyboard man to sing, then we all dance and we are excited. But when you find people that are hungry, then you can now begin to talk kingdom talk. Okay. Can we digress? Let's digress a little, because in the idea of creation, there are two sides to it. We have the invincible side, and according to scriptures, the invincible side is more concrete than the visible side, because Paul said, "Why we look not on the things that are seen, for the things that are seen are temporal, and the things that are not seen are eternal." So in that comparison, Paul was saying that the invisible aspect of creation is more concrete than the visible. Therefore, if you decide to pursue the visible, the reason for your pursuit, the reason for which you are exercising faith, the reason for your prayer, are things that are visible. You need a car quickly. You need to get married. It will interest you to know that you did not come here to get married. That's not why you are here. Because you don't know what man is. That's why your preoccupation is marriage. Marriage itself is temporary, it's physical. As powerful as it is. I have a very good wife. So don't think that I have family problem. That's the reason for which I am saying what I don't have family. Yes. Where was I? I was in Onitsha. Then I called my wife and told her that I have come to the conclusion that in all the world, you are the best one for me. So we are on top level, top gear. So I don't have family problem. I'm just teaching you the Bible. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Now, there are ministers whose ministry is focused on this realm. That ministry is a deception. Because the way you are supposed to evaluate this realm is based on your intercourse, your participation in the realm of your reality. That's how you relate with this. That's how you relate with money. That's how you relate with people. That's how you relate with material things. But if you don't know what you are, you might find yourself in a rat race. and you squander your life on an elective. Are you still with me? I'm still testing to know. It was Jesus that said in the book of Matthew chapter 23 verse 23, he was rebuking the scribes and the Pharisees. Give me Matthew 23:23. This is what Jesus said. Matthew 23:23. He said, "Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites." Why? Why did he call them hypocrites? Remember, these guys are the custodians of revelatory powers in their time. The thing about their ministry that Jesus summarized it in that word, hypocrite. Meanwhile, in the book of Matthew, Jesus uses the word hypocrite quite frequently. He used hypocrite when he was teaching prayer. It means there is a prayer hypocrite. He used hypocrite when he was teaching on fasting. It means there's a fasting hypocrite. Should I go on? This particular hypocrite is using here is for preachers. So they are preacher hypocrites, according to Jesus. These preacher hypocrites is not as if they are not sound in doctrine. The rebuke that Jesus was bringing to them was not lack of theological soundness. The rebuke that Jesus was bringing to them was the emphasis of their ministry. Stay with me. Don't judge me yet until we read the Bible. And then we discuss it. Then you can judge me. He said, "Hypocrites, for ye pay tithe of mint." Mint is a, you know, mint leaf now. Of anise. Anise is like curry. And cumin is a spice. And I've omitted the weightier matters of the law. What made these guys hypocrites is that they were majoring on electives. And they forsook the weightier matters of the law. So their disciples were going to be people that were experts in the trivia. Are you with me? The doctrine is sound, but the emphasis is trivia. At the end of the day, Jesus did not say that they should stop teaching on tithe. Just in case there's a pastor that wants to crucify me, because I'm feeling the tension of. Jesus called for balance as the proof that you are not a hypocrite. You have omitted the weightier matters of the law, then he mentioned a few. Judgment, mercy, and faith. He said, "This ought ye to have done and not to leave the other undone." What exactly makes these few aspects that Jesus mentioned to be weightier? What is it that makes it weightier? Oh, you are not following me. So let's leave it. Since you... We'll go back to our chat. Some aspects of creation are invincible. Colossians chapter 1 verse 16. Give me that on the screen. Colossians 1 16. "For by him were all things created." Now, listen to me. Listen. If you notice that your baby is crying and you don't have any skills to comfort the child, don't allow the crying to distract us. For by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible. It means there are two sides to creation. We have the invisible side. We have what? Did you get that? Then he now gave us a list of items that are part of creation. If you study this list very well, you will find out that on this list, there is nothing visible that is on that list. Whether there be thrones. So it means that we cannot talk about the invisible realm without talking about thrones. Do you know what thrones are? And do you even know why it's in the plural? It means we cannot talk about the invisible realm without talking about principalities. It means we cannot talk about the invisible realm without talking about powers. That is the reason for which I said the invisible realm, no, that thing you are playing is wrong. See, young man, is there anybody that can play the keyboard here that plays well? You play well? Now, that thing you are playing, it means you don't know where I am in the spirit. You are just playing it because you learned it. It is not yet a ministry for you. It's still visible. What you are doing is visible. So take another 20 minutes to pray and ask God to help you. Then start again. Now, are you following me? As far as Jesus is concerned, don't let me tell you that thing again. Mother. This is a serious business. We have speakers everywhere. You can stand in a comfortable location and you'll still be following the service and the baby will not be a distraction to us. Now listen, as far as Apostle Paul is concerned, the invisible realm is more concrete than the visible. That means we are even supposed to know the invisible realm more than the visible. What do you know about the invisible realm? What do you know about it? I just showed you three things. What are thrones? Okay. Let's leave it. You are not interested. Now, it will interest you to know this fact as we make progress gradually. In the entire enterprise of creation, this visible creation, the ones we have account of in the book of Genesis, there is no creature that God created that had legitimacy to operate in this physical world and in the supernatural world except man. Just stay with me, stay with me. No, don't be moved to clap, because we will not even know who you are clapping for. So let's take it easy. With your spirit, you have legitimacy to operate. this room. Only man is like that. Now the question is, why did God create man? Because every other creature, are you there? Every other creature that God created in the enterprise of creation is original. It's only man that is not original. Stay with me. Don't think you know what I'm saying. Just stay with me first. You don't know what a mantle. A goat, for instance, was created after its kind. That means the best example of a goat is a goat. Hey there. But when it came to man, man was created after the God kind. Are you with me? Was created in the image of God, not created in the image of man, not after man's kind. Why? According to design, man was created to function. This is design, not whether we are operating according to design. I'm just saying the person that created us had an intention. Just like Mercedes-Benz, they have an intention before they went into manufacturing. And if you have driven one of the recent Mercedes-Benz, there is no steering like it. To maneuver, it's as if you are holding a pencil. The man that manufactured that car had an intention in mind. That's why the car is like that. He kept trying until he arrived at that product. So if you are driving that car, it means you are experiencing his intention. So God that created us with an intention in mind, and the design for man is that he should be created in the image of God. That's one. Are you there? Yes, sir. Do you realize, according to the royal decree of Psalms 115, verse 16, which says, the heavens, even the heavens belongs to God, but the earth has he given unto the sons of men. That's a royal decree that reveals jurisdiction. From the day God made that decree, it is illegal for God to invade the earth without man's permission. It's an illegal thing. It's a breach of territorial integrity. It's a breach of systems and authority. So why did God put himself in that condition where he can now be outlawed from the earth? Why? Are you following me? Good. He created man in his image. And I know that you have seen hand gloves before. Have you seen it? Hand gloves are created in the image of a hand because the idea, the vision of the manufacturer is that it will play host to a hand. Man was created in the image of God because God intended that man will play host to him. So the reason why God didn't consider it a risk to wield this aspect of his creation under the authority of man is because he created your spirit as an accommodation for himself. So if God wants to come into the earth, what he does is that he will wear your spirit. Then you will be the one. We are trying to answer the question, what is man? Are you with me? Do you still remember the book of John chapter 4 when Jesus was trying to educate a woman at the well? And I told her, because she was arguing about the location, the accurate, most accurate location for worship. And she was suggesting to Jesus that her ancestors told her that on the mountains of Samaria, that's the most holy place, site for worship. And then the Jews now say, Jerusalem is the most holy ground that men ought to worship. And Jesus said, both are wrong. But the time is coming, and in fact, that time has already begun, where the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and reality. That means your spirit man, in regeneration, it is configured according to the wiring of the Holy Ghost, making your spirit man. How many of you use MTN? What of Globe? Which one do we have again? Airtel. Huh? Nine Mobile. You have all of them? You have two. Do you have them on the same phone or on different phones? Now, have you ever had a situation where you're yeah, no. Are they not SIM cards? How come your Globe network never tapped into MTN signals? Oh boy, the thing don't they catch MTN no. I'm using these examples because I want us to travel in our mind first. When you give your life to Christ, meanwhile, I know Apostle Tonya uses most of the classic. I know your phones are. He's a modern man. When you get a phone, you can use the touch light without a SIM card. You can use the calculator on the phone without a SIM card. The phone has benefits that you can enjoy apart from inserting a SIM card. Are you there? So everything that you are using is local. That's how a human being is. Even if you are not born again, you have some functions that can operate. You can go to school and go to University of Calabar and come out the best student in your class. What you are using to exercise that academic dominion is not in Christ, it's in Adam. Because Adam was not born again, he didn't have the life of God when he received the dominion mandate. Are you following me? Now, I will show you that dominion is in three levels. We have the Adamic dominion. If any of us here had ever been to China and you see the skyscrapers and the technology, it's not Christ's. It's just Adam. Adam too has the capacity for actualization, but the scope of his operation is local. Just like the ability of your phone without a SIM card is local content. It's what is already installed on the phone that can work with that local ability. So man has installed capacity for dominion in his local content. And you can operate at that level and even win a Guinness Book of World Records. But you see, if our evaluation of what you have done, because there is a confusion in the body of Christ now, somebody builds a cathedral that can house so many thousands of people, he is now a reference point. Meanwhile, the things he has done and local content. Because Paul says, as long as you can see something, it is temporal. Our perspective of relevance is a function of, that's our scale of measurement. It means something, a terrible damage has been done to our understanding of what man is. Are you still with me? Meanwhile, Abraham earned three titles in the spirit. He earned the title of the father of faith. He earned the title of a friend of God. He earned the title of father of many nations. Such that Jews, Christians, and Muslims claim him to be their ancestor. Think about it. Was it because he built an auditorium? Are you feeling? When Jesus came to actualize redemption, according to the book of Galatians chapter 3, the coming of Jesus was in keeping with the foundation of the covenant that God made with Abraham. So redemption actually began with Abraham. The process of redemption began with Abraham. That process saw the light of actualization when Jesus paid and satisfied the claims of divine justice. Think about it first before we go on. So, in the book of Galatians chapter 3, the Bible now reveals that if any one of us accepted Jesus by faith, we have our designation is that we are children of Abraham. So the very foundation upon which the sacrifice of Jesus was efficacious judicial position to redeem humankind was based on an agreement God made with a human being. Meanwhile, today we celebrate people in our midst with achievements that we can see through the lens of the natural. But Abraham's stature was not natural. Think about it. So when the Bible says someone is great in the sight of God, what does it mean? If you don't know who a man is, you don't even know the definition of greatness. As we study, you will discover that greatness is better than blessing. Have you drawn the chart I say you should draw?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If you go to the invincible side, the first personality in the invincible side, the topmost ranking personality in the invisible side is God. Are you there? You are not there. You following? If you come to the visible side, the topmost ranking personality in the visible side is man. If you go to the invisible side, some other subordinate personalities in the visible side, we can add angel. So, God has authority over angels. Huh? If you come to the physical side or the visible side, you can now write animal under man. So man has authority over animal. You don't need to pray before you address that your chicken. Huh? It's not a prayer point. Are you following? Even though man in the physical side is number one, but according to the book of Psalms 82, because Psalm 82 is another scripture we need to consult in order to be able to answer the question, what is man? Are you with me? Can you give me Psalms 82 before we start this lecture? Let's go around first. Then we'll now start the lecture. The lecture begins in Matthew chapter 14. Stay with me. Psalms 82 verse 1 says, God standeth in the congregation of the mighty. He judgeth amongst the gods. That's verse 1. If you see this scripture, there is a temptation for you to think that God wants to wage war with Amadioha. Contend with. But you need to hold on. so that we understand who these gods are. Yes. Are you with me?
Yes,
second thing I need to draw your attention to, the God of the Bible does not need to stand. Oh, you are not aware. God doesn't rule by strength. He rules by decrees. The first time words were used in the Bible was not for communication, it was for creation. If he says it, it is done. That's how he rules. So you don't need to stand to talk. You need to, before you talk, are you there? You don't need to stand to talk. I'm still learning the Bible. But so I can make this statement this way. Within the limits of my own understanding and study of the Bible, God stood in the entire Bible 2 times. This is one. Second time we saw him standing was when they were about to kill Stephen, and he looked into heaven. He had the gift of discernment of spirit. He saw Jesus doing what? And in the 2 occasions where God stood, it was for the same purpose. It was for the purpose of judgment. That in the day when God wants to judge, that day, in the court of heaven, he stands before him. So this particular day, the purpose for which God was standing was that he wanted to judge, and it's the gods that he wanted to judge. As we continue in the study, you will discover that these guys they call gods are actually men. Just stay with me for a moment. These gods are men that God gave authority and God capacities in measures of grace, so that they can be competent to take care of some of his business. You see, are you with me? The kingdom of God is a different kingdom from any other kingdom that you have ever known. Because in human kingdoms, what you have is a king and subjects. Then also. But in the kingdom of God, we have a different system. In his own kingdom, it is king and kings. That's why the thrones are many.
Yeah. Come on.
Are you following? Yeah. That's why the thrones are many. You know, when we read Colossians chapter 1, we now took note that the thrones are many. That's how the kingdom of God is. It is king and kings. Is because they are under kings that take care of jurisdictions, they take care of territories, they take care of some of God's business. And because they are going to operate in representative capacity, God now gives them authority and then he gives them mantles. Unfortunately for these gods, they use the authority to do the opposite of what God gave them the authority to achieve. Next verse. How long will he judge unjustly and accept the persons of the wicked? So these guys, they teamed up with wicked people to oppress the people that God anointed them to deliver. Go on, go on. Next one. Then he now gives them a lecture of how they should have operated. Defend the poor and the fatherless. Do justice to the afflicted and the needy. Do you still remember the book of Judges? When the people are oppressed, then God raises a judge. It's a normal man like them. But the moment a mantle comes upon him, he begins to exercise what we call the stature of leadership. It's not as if he has a throne that he's sitting on. Are you there? It's not as if he won an election and then they gave him a platform to operate from. Are you there? A mantle comes upon him, and you will need to be blind and totally ignorant for you not to acknowledge the fact that there is an enablement that this man has that has installed him as a leader. Are you aware that Moses was the first king of Israel? Oh, you're not aware of that? No, no. Go to Deuteronomy chapter 33. Are you there? Are you going to Deuteronomy? Chapter 33, not 23, 3:3. And this is the blessing wherewith Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel before his death. He said, the Lord came from Sinai and rose up from Seir unto them and shined forth from Mount Paran and came with 10,000s of saints. From his right hand went a fiery law for them. Next verse. Yea, he loved the people. All the saints are in thy hand, and they sat down at thy feet. Everyone shall receive thy words. Moses commanded us a law, even the inheritance of the congregation of Jacob. And he was king in Jeshurun. Stop there. I hope you know the meaning of Jeshurun. That's the nick, another name for Israel. That is a nickname for Israel. He was king in Jeshurun. Moses had, he walked in the anointing of kingship over the house of Israel before there was a throne for that king. There was no physical throne, but Moses was already walking in the anointing of a king. Do you get what a mantle is? In the elections that were conducted in order for the head of a certain ministry to emerge, there was rigging and such manipulation as is equivalent to what is obtainable in the political scenario. After that process that it makes a leader, are you sure the spiritual aspect of that responsibility will be on that man? Just I know you are not answering, but the question I'm trying to ask this morning is, what is? What exactly? Moses walked in the anointing of a king before a throne was carved out for Israel. It was, are you there? It was in his this kingly anointing that he gave them a law. You want to give a people a law and you are not a, you don't have the status of a king. Or you create one law now, let's see. He gave the people a law, and the people, their life was bound by that law. Now he was about to die. Are you there? Okay, let's go. Let's probe deeper into this verse. He was king in Jeshurun Then the next word there is when. It means he was not king every time. He was not carrying the kingly anointing every time. He only carried the kingly anointing when the heads of the people and the tribes of Israel were gathered together. When the heads of the clans gather, the heads of the tribes gather, if he stands in their midst, then the kingly anointing will come. So now Moses, you know, I read verse 1 and I said this is the blessing wherewith Moses, the servant of God, blessed Israel before his death. So they knew he was going to die, so he wanted to arrange send off. So in the send off ceremony, he asked for all the elders of the, so that he can enter into the kingly anointing to make some declaration. The things he made here, the utterances he gave here, were not prophecies. He was speaking from his capacity as a king. And everything he said came to pass because of the authority from whence he was speaking. Are you with me? You are not following. You are not following. Okay, for instance, let me use Benson Idahosa. He spoke from this place. He spoke in the capacity of the throne that was set up to regulate Nigeria. Not this political throne that INEC, I don't know. They need to test INEC staff for mental, for if there is, for insanity. I don't know if the psychiatric hospital in the teaching hospital here is robust enough. Because, hallelujah. Because what we have in Nigeria is a nation that was kidnapped. And I don't want to go there. I don't want to go there. A nation is moving like this. Human beings came and came. In case you are not aware, just in case you are not aware, it is possible you are not aware. So that's why I want to say whatever. The actual governing thrones of judges for every nation exist. Not these political thrones. That governing throne is a spiritual throne. And people that occupy that throne can regulate politics, can regulate. The throne of Nigeria has been vacant. That throne has been vacant since Idahosa left. No Nigerian has ever been anointed like that. Wait, just stay. Wait. Now, can we agree that you will not waste my time with clapping? We are trying to talk about men. Anytime a nation does not have a king, you will see lawlessness. Those are indications of the fact that the throne is vacant. Because if when Moses was alive, what he did was that he gave them a law that regulated them. As rebellious as Israel, the reason why God chose Israel is because they were number one in rebellion. Just to show all the nations that if I can deal with Israel, I can deal with you. And in that rebellious nation, Moses rose up with the hand of God, and the people bowed. Are you with me? So one of us rose, and he was not operating in the anointing of prophet ministers. The grace he carried was the grace of a judge. It's territorial. Why is it that people claim to have the gift of word of knowledge and it's only people in the church they see? Can't you use that gift to tell the military where Boko Haram is? Think about it. He knows your phone number, he knows your name, but he doesn't know where Boko Haram is. Well, I don't want to press because there are many ministers here. Some might be offended that I'm saying this. You are so accurate. You know people's underwear. You don't know. Yeah, you don't know the name of the kidnapper that is troubling Calabar. You don't know his heart. You can't help the police with intelligence. Do you think that's a throne? If you see a throne operating, even an unbeliever will accept that there is God in him. Meanwhile, I don't want to talk because people, the hatred, the hatred that people hate me in this small meal that I have, you know. I went to one country to minister, and one of our brothers was there. As I came, the problem I met on ground was that he used Facebook, a Facebook conversation he had with somebody as prophecy. And those guys are smart. He didn't check to know that some nations in Africa, they have more, in terms of academics, they are higher than us. They are smart guys. He didn't check. So he did what he used to do around. Did it there. They now tracked it. And is that a throne? The Lord will help us. Amen. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
That man is a territorial minister. That man is not a pulpit minister. He can renovate the territory. Now, this is the kind of grace that Moses operated in. So, if he wants to operate the kingly anointing, he calls all the elders of the tribes and the clans. Once he stands in their midst, he can access the kingly anointing that was ordained to power Israel, even though there was no physical throne present. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now let us see how he used the power. Yeah? Next, verse 6. The first thing he did when he accessed that oil was what? He said, let Reuben what?
Leave.
I hope you know Reuben's story. It was his father that laid a curse on him that began to take effect. But this guy was not operating with the anointing of a father. He was operating with the anointing of the king of Israel. He could overrule what the father did. As legitimate as a father's stake is on his child. When this man stepped into the kingly anointing, he reversed that pronouncement. I said, yeah, okay, your father said this, but in the capacity of a king, I decree, let Reuben what?
Leave.
Do you realize that it is possible for INEC to even declare an election? And then somebody that has that throne comes and say, oh, right. They say you came late. Now you came late. If you had spoken before this time, say, you know how many generations later Moses showed up and it was not late. The moment that authority came into view, what did he say? Let Reuben be. Go back to Psalms 82. I think you are following me now.
Yes, sir.
So God began to educate these gods. He said, deliver the poor and the needy. Rid them out of the hand of the wicked. This is what they were supposed to do. So God is such a meticulous personality. Even though he came to judge, he will first take you for lectures and show you what you should have done so that you yourself, you accept your judgment as just before he will begin to pronounce it. I don't want to go next. Verse 5 is still educating them about the privileges that they enjoyed in authority, that they used to plunge the entire physical creation into darkness. I don't want to go into that. Verse 6, quickly. Are you there? Then he said, this verse 6 is my emphasis, actually. Verse 6 and 7. Verse 7 is the judgment. Verse 6 is my emphasis. It says, I have said. That means this is my... You know, we are investigating man. Don't get lost. We are still on that subject. He said, I have said, ye are gods. He's talking to men. Have you read the book of Luke chapter 10? Jesus was speaking and he said, if he called them gods unto whom the word of the Lord came, and the scriptures cannot be broken. It was on that count that Jesus said the scriptures cannot. Have you read your scripture when the Bible says that God made Moses a god unto Pharaoh? He made him an authority unto Pharaoh. An authority that Pharaoh, who is king, must obey. You see, are you there? It is possible for you not to have a political throne. But you are brought into a certain context that has to do with an administrative jurisdiction in the spirit. And then the accompaniment for that level of ordination becomes a mantle. And anyone that violates the authority of that mantle comes down with bitter judgment instantly to make people understand that you are carrying something. It's not as if you will do a billboard in town and say, the gods are here. Before daybreak, people will tear that billboard and nothing will happen. It's not billboard matter I'm talking about. I'm talking about something that stands on a man and he can make nonsense of human political leadership because he is sitting in the spiritual capacity of the patron of the territory. Think about it before we go on. Should I say something quickly? Do you realize that Jesus in the days of his flesh did not have a pulpit? Think about it. So it means that Jesus' ministry was territorial. Some of the miracles that you saw in the Bible that Jesus performed were done under normal life circumstances. People are going for burial, singing song. Naked I came, naked I shall return with the Holy Ghost. So people are singing and going to the graveyard, and then Jesus now says, what is happening? Then they say, are you mad? Are you not? He say, sorry. Then he touches the coffin. The reason for the procession, the singing, he has ended it. So he has made nonsense of the... And there are people there that have made up their mind that they will cry. Even those people are disappointed because the object, the... Then he will allow them go home and discuss what happened. So there were debates in different corners in the market. All they were discussing was Jesus. And when the discussion goes high, then he will now be passing in the market. The whole market will start. Oh my God. If you are a minister of the gospel, don't die here. There's something more than this one. If you really have a mantle operating on your life, your power, your ability will not end here. You can become, it will become territorial. You can walk into the market and see a blind person and say, in the name of Jesus, rise. You didn't need any praise and worship to make that happen. I say, no, the thing is not, they are not balancing the sound. It's not the sound, there's nothing there. There is nothing there. The people are trying, the sound men are trying their best. It's just that there is nothing. Check in the entire Old Testament, you will never see a prophet that had a pulpit because their ministries were territorial. In fact, many of them operated from the palace. They were counselors. Their visions helped nations to come into alignment. We can see people's underwear. This is underwear now. Hi, Jesus Christ. I did a lecture on a New Testament prophet, and all over the internet they say teachers are fighting prophets. Did you see that thing? Because the estimation, those guys that claim that they are prophets, just try to listen to him. He can't make a complete Bible, he can't sustain a Bible discussion for 30 minutes. How did you become a prophet? He can't sustain a Bible discussion in 10 minutes. He's just scattered, just saying rubbish. Then he will say, okay, somebody, your underwear is blue. Blue underwear. Listen, you must know. Are you there? If your revelation, if your manifestation is much more than your revelation in the world, you are using divination. Your manifestations are supposed to be commensurate to your revelations in the world. And the Lord appeared again to Samuel in Shiloh and revealed himself to Samuel by the word of the Lord. So I just wanted to alert the whole continent that the people you call prophets are imposters and rogues, thieves. They should start cults, not churches. You start something like Black Axe and gather gangs together, not churches. There is a way a man of God is. You must have been taught the language of scriptures to the point where you think in scriptures. Can't make a complete statement in the word of God for 35 minutes. You say you are a prophet. Okay. Where? Prophet, you are sleeping with everything around. And you are a prophet. That is divination. People, in my village, they have people that operate in divination. The fuel for the operation is immorality. And they don't hide it. This is our way. This is our priesthood. I was away from home for 11 years because of national assignment. 11 years. I never touched a woman. Because Jesus trained me before I started ministry. Now I do international ministry. Even if I travel alone, my wife knows I'll come back intact. Because, yes, 11 years. Not 11 months. Years. If you have problems with immorality, your place is not the pulpit. No. Your place, open a mechanic shop where they repair vehicles. Your place is not the pulpit. Stop deceiving yourself. Your place is not. Yeah, it's not the pulpit. So don't deceive. You are wasting people's time. Wasting people's time. It is because of such people that people can't believe genuine ministers again. And they have such a very bogus sense of entitlement that they believe that they should not be challenged. Meanwhile, we are not challenging you as you. You are not even important. We are just bringing the word of God to check. This is what the word of God says. Just drop it there. And it becomes serious crisis. Meanwhile, what we drop there is the word of God. It's not our preference. This is supposed to be the regulating factor of all our activities. You don't subscribe to regulation. Someone that is confronting with the word of God has love for your soul, because you see, the context of what you are doing is just earthly. You are not a man. That's Adam. That's the falling. And that it is Adam that I wanted to talk about, that I brought you here. Because some people think that Adam is man. Adam is not, it's a mutation. It's not the idea. Not the idea. When you mount this throne that we are talking about, money will look for you. You don't need to do, you say, okay, if you want this, this is the singlet that I use to go to the mountain. I sweat, the anointing of sweat is upon it. So if you want to, money will look for you. We'll look for you. So we have the ability and the authority to say no. Even if you want to give us money, we say no. You know why? Because money looks for us. The reason why we'll see you is because God told us to see you, not because of anything else. There's nothing you can give us. Nothing. And I assure you, practically, nothing. Are you still with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, let's finish up and go to Matthew. Well, yes. You are released. Touch him. I will guide you. You see, if you don't play that instrument, I'll be a teacher. If you play that instrument, I'll be a prophet. So, what I'm trying to do is to migrate. But the problem is, you need to strike the sound in the spirit. What the sound? You need to look for it. Okay. Try. I'll guide you. Now, he said, I've said ye are gods. And all of you are children of the Most High. That's the difference between, are you with me?
Yes.
You know, in the chat, I told you, in the invisible side, God is number one. In the visible side, man is number one. But ye are children of the Most High. It means that your authority is not original. Your authority is delegated. It means my alignment to God is what determines the authority I walk in. If you see somebody that is beginning to walk naked of authority, it means he has lost his alignment with God. Human beings might have various ways of trying to give people relevance other than authority. But in the kingdom of God, a man's description is consistent with the authority that he has from God. With great power, the apostles gave witness of the resurrection of Jesus, the Bible says, and great grace was upon them. The difference between the apostles and the brethren was that the apostles had great grace. You couldn't deny that God has deliberately put something on this man in order for the world's attention to be gained by them. It is God that orchestrates real kingdom visibility. Not handbills and posters, not Facebook and WhatsApp. And great grace was upon them. Great grace was upon them. You see, as you prayed, God has heard you. Now, when will I get to this, my Matthew? So, are you seeing it now? He said, you are children of the Most High. Even though you are high, there is one that is called the Most High. and you are children of the Most High. That means you draw your authority, your relevance, your significance. It is because of the assignment he has given you. That is our basis of evaluation now. Even people that do witchcraft, they invoke darkness on food and take to motherless babies as a strategy for exchange. So what do you mean by generosity? What generosity? Are you talking about exchange philanthropy? Is your definition for generosity exchange philanthropy? You are not with me. You are not answering me. He said, for thou hast crowned him with glory and honor. Man is a crowned being. He's supposed to be a crowned being. The word crown in Hebrew is medallion. That medal that athletes win when they participate in a race. Are you with me? It's a medallion. That has a, maybe it's gold. Gold here. So it's a crown bee. So the crown is not this crown. The crown is this crown. But the Bible says that we have this treasure in 18 verses. It's a crown of the heart. The Holy Spirit having a place in his heart. That's the description of man. For the Bible says that it's the Spirit that helpeth our infirmities. So in the natural, you are incapacitated. In the natural, you are full of weaknesses. And God's antidote to all of your weaknesses is in the Holy Ghost. So the idea of a man is man plus Holy Ghost. Man that is depending on the Holy Ghost. That's what the psalmist meant when he says, I will look to the hills. From whence cometh my help? Because mortal man is insufficient in himself. And what swallows up your insufficiency as ordained by God is the Holy Ghost, for it is the Spirit that helpeth. Do you know the Holy Ghost? Do you know him? When you have a problem, where do you run to? You begin to hustle. It means you don't know the Holy Ghost. People that know the Holy Ghost, they depend on him for every answer. So I did not succeed in opening my mouth. There are seven definitions of the man that God conceived in the book of Genesis when he says, let us make one. Okay, let me give you one so that you will not say the man refused to preach his message. In Luke chapter 18, verse 1. The Bible says that he spake a parable to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. Normally, Jesus will give you a parable, then his disciples will come to him, ask for the meaning, then he will analyze it, explain it, and then come with the lesson of the parable. This time, Jesus gives the parable, the lesson first, before he gives the parable. And he says, the parable is long, and you are likely to forget the lesson, so let us start with the lesson. He spake a parable to this end, that men, humankind, were designed as creatures of prayer. That's the design. And that's the reason why you have a spirit that can access a spirit realm. You have a body that can access this physical realm. So that you can access things in the spirit and then implement here. That is what priesthood is. Prayer is earthly permission for heavenly interference. Prayer is we saying, come and help us. Because of jurisdiction issues, God will only come on invitation. And just in case the activities of God around your life are scarce, it means your prayer life is dead. Man is a creature of prayer. He's designed to be a creature of prayer. Human beings, because of the fall, we labor to find alternative technologies apart from prayer. Yes, the flesh has that instinct. But in any other way that you have discovered that you are operating now, that secludes prayer, that way is called malfunctioning. You are malfunctioning. That wisdom that you got it in the flesh, because the flesh doesn't like prayer. He created man as a being of prayer. And the opposite of prayer is fainting, not prayerless. There's no prayerless in the Bible, it's fainting. It means you are living on life support. You are a victim of anxiety, victim of the politics of the land, victim of the economy. You are moving like Simon. I hope you know Simon means a weed by the seashore. It has no true stem, so the waters determine how it. That's why Jesus changed his name. You shall no longer be called Simon. Every circumstance will bend you. Poverty make you a liar. Pressure make you commit fornication. You will become a different creature outside of your ordination if you don't embrace prayer now. Are you with me? When we were growing up, I like scriptures. I can stay on it for days. But I didn't like prayer. So I now did a topical study on prayer. And then discovered that I cannot survive without it. So I started learning. I will go to people that I envy their prayer life. How are you doing this thing? See, this thing is not a formula. Just start practicing. Start practicing. We were taught that if you put stones in your pocket in the night and you want to sleep, when the bed presses on the stone, you will wake up. My flesh now modified and I could sleep comfortably with stone. They say, okay, if you put your leg inside water, that sleep will go away. It became a condition. Then I went to God himself and said, how does a man like me become a man of prayer? Then he took me to the book of Psalms 80, verse 18. He says, so we will not depart from thee. Quicken us, and we shall call upon thy name. Oh! So I now discovered that it was not my responsibility to quicken myself. So when I speak in tongues, I wait for the Holy Ghost to quicken me. Then I now understood what the Bible meant when it says, we'll mount up with wings like the eagles. Prayer became a lifestyle. 24 hours is too short these days. Too short. You say you want to pray, before you know it, 7 hours has gone, 15 hours. The day has. If not for the meeting, if you put me in a hotel, say, hey, you are welcome, put me in a hotel. I will never come out of my room until I'm coming to preach. Sometimes when I'm being called to preach, the Lord will dispatch an angel, we'll be discussing, and then they'll say, come and preach. That men ought always to pray and not to faint. There's a way you can adorn yourself. Spirits from the water will look at you and go backward. Can somebody exercise his spirit and say, Lord, I contact the spirit of supplication. I contact the spirit of intercession. So that we can mount up with wings like the eagles. So that we can run and not be weary. So that we can do the supernatural naturally. And do the natural supernaturally. Siamo teni mahabesco. Sila mehila. Sanena nobela bena. Jai la kobeneza. Oh. Sanena nanele. Sanena nanele. Sanena nanele. Our infirmity, swallow up our weaknesses. Before your presence we come, we ask that you strengthen us with might by your spirit in the inner man.
Yo. sopino que no ya ni dominicano lero.
To pray and not to faint. Baptize us afresh. Let us not be weary in the affairs of prayer. Baptize us afresh. Let us not be faint. These are the days where we need to rescue our nation from darkness. Strengthen us. Strengthen us. Let weariness be passed from us. The capacity to mount up with wings, to mount up like the eagles.
Someone that is sick that is not here, you can switch on your phone, call the person, and the person is seriously sick, maybe bedridden. I want us to seize the opportunity to spread the scope of the blessings
to other people that are not here. So you have 2 minutes to call the person and keep your phone running while I pray. Is that possible? That's the first instruction. Second instruction. Are you with me? Maybe you use glasses, you are short-sighted, you are long-sighted, and you want to use your eyes without the glasses. Remove the glasses, just lay your hands on the eyes. Is there anybody in the congregation that you have one of your ears deaf? If you want that ear to hear again, take this finger, put it in the ear that cannot hear, close it completely till I ask you to release it. If you have issues with paralysis, you cannot walk without an aid, and you are on this ground or you are participating online, put your hand on your legs that are paralyzed. Then we'll just pray a simple prayer and let us trust the Lord to touch people. Any form of pain, you had an accident and there's a pain that came out of the accident, touch it. Is there a growth, fibroid, cancer, tumor, and you can feel it? Put your hand where the tumor is, where the cancer is. Just hold it there. Just hold it there. Where the fibroid is, just hold it there. If I say in the name of Jesus, give me a big amen. Let's test. In the name of Jesus. 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 Father, in the name of Jesus, we bind every sickness. We bind every disease. We bind every curse. We bind every affliction. Blinding spirits be bound. Deafening spirits be bound. Come out of the eyes in the name of Jesus. Come out of the ears in the name of Jesus. I rebuke every spirit of paralysis. I said, take your hands in the name of Jesus. Take your hands in the name of Jesus. Take your hands in the name of Jesus. I command every pain, come out in the name of Jesus Christ. Of infirmity and curses, let it be rolled away in the name of Jesus. Satan, take off your hands in the name of Jesus. I command the eyes, see in Jesus' name. I command the ears, hear in Jesus' name. I command the bones, come together, bone to bone, in the name of Jesus Christ. Those that are participating online will send the healing power of God your way this afternoon in the name of Jesus. Those that are connecting through phone, we release the power of God your way in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Receive your sight, receive your sight, receive your sight, receive your sight. Now, I'm seeing a woman that finds it difficult to even sleep in the night, and when she gets a little sleep and there's some disturbance, she wakes up and it's almost impossible for her to get back to sleep. And I see the demon responsible for this affliction that is upon this woman. Meanwhile, oh woman, wave your hand, let me see. So I say to you today, in the name of Jesus Christ, the yoke of restlessness is broken over you in Jesus' name. Somebody went for a burial, and since you came back from that burial, unknown to you, a spiritual arrow was shot at you. And since you came back from the burial, you've been seeing dead people in your dreams. Dead people. Let me see your hand. That power of necromancy that is coming against you, we destroy it in the name of Jesus Christ. There are two eyes that are already healed. No, don't believe now. No. Two eyes are already healed. There's someone with a lung condition. You used to suffer from asthma, and you felt a sharp pain on your lungs while we prayed. I would like to see you. So if you notice, check yourself. If you notice that there is a change, come here. Check first, confirm, like your eye, try to read, your ear, ask somebody to speak. Run your test for like 2 minutes. When you have confirmed, okay, you will help me? All right. So, you have 2 minutes to check, but wait. I will move to the second item, so that I can give you 2 minutes, enough time to check. The third eye has opened. The third eye. Now, so the people healed on the eyes can be more than three, but they cannot be less than three. That's what I mean by that. The first thing God says we do, I will take just five testimonies later, is that there are some female intercessors he wants to set apart. That's the first. We're talking about mantle. So if you are a woman or a lady, put your hand in. Then I will pray. The people that God will conscript, He will identify them by a touch of the anointing. Father, in the name of Jesus, these priestesses of the altar, women that will pour out fragrance and make obeisance before you continually, standing in the gap for their families, for their territories, for your work in this land and indeed in this nation, that you said that you were going to conscript for this holy assignment during the course of this conference, I ask that you stretch forth your hand from my left hand side to the back to the forward to the members of the choir. Anyone that you have chosen among the women standing here, identify by a touch of the anointing. 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 By a touch, 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 by a touch of the anointing. Is it possible for me to lay
my hands on them, just one touch. Is it possible? Is it possible? Now listen. 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 Those of you here, I want to give you something. To do is stretch your right hand towards me, okay? Father, those ones that you have chosen in this choir to make their voice heard in the ministry of praise and worship, I ask, upgrade them by a touch of the anointing. Upgrade them by a touch of the anointing. Upgrade them by a touch of the anointing. Upgrade them by a touch of the anointing, 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 by a touch of the anointing. Holy Ghost! Now, let me just touch this lady. Is it possible? Now, if you have checked yourself and you have confirmed that there is a miracle, come and meet me here. This is the spot. You have checked and you have confirmed that there is a change. You stand here. Now, listen. Now, ushers, you don't know your work. I gave you an instruction. I said, I just want to come, let me teach you what I'm talking about. These people that God has chosen, I need to touch them like this. Huh? I didn't say gather here. Hey! Okay. I can't obey God here. If you notice that your eye can see, there are at least three people whose eyes have been corrected. If you call somebody on the phone, call them now to confirm. Call them now to confirm how their condition is, how their situation is. Now, I just want to touch you. Just a touch. I didn't ask you to come. It's this ones that God has touched. Are you the ones that brought these ones? Or they just came? They came. Are you sure? Wait, let's confirm if they are among them. Man of God. Let them stand there. I will tell you when to talk. Are you among them? Why are you here? No, don't worry. Go and sit down. Sit down. Me and you, you are my protocol. Why are you coming? Look, no, don't walk. The Lord comes upon you from today. Oh my God. 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 I am seeing
am seeing there are still 7 women left. Father, in the name of Jesus, anywhere these women are, stretch forth your hand. Identify them by a touch of the anointing, 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 by a touch. Listen, I am seeing the Bible opening. There's someone that God wants to give a very strong teaching anointing. The Bible is opening, and in the next 21 seconds, the hand of God will come upon that person. I don't know if the person is a pastor, but in 21 seconds, the hand of God will descend upon the person. Father, anywhere this teacher is, let the anointing of a teacher, let it rest upon him. Let the anointing of revelation rest upon him. Let the spirit of wisdom and revelation rest. There are about 3 people in the overflow outside. There are about 3 side among these women. And the hand of God will descend upon them. Father, descend on them. 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 Holy Ghost. Here because of 3 individuals, and the hand of God will identify them. Okay, I've seen one. Bring that lady, bring her. It's very important. Father, in the name of Jesus. Okay, there is still one more. The fire of God will come upon one of you. What I give you will stay with you. It will empower you. It will empower you. It will give you the capacity to mount up in the spirit. To mount up in the spirit. The fire of God will come upon one lady outside here. It will come so powerfully, come so strong. Father,
That lady. Arrest that lady.
Special grace that will equip you, will empower you, so that you will stop crying. It's time to mount up with wings in the spirit. Receive grace in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. Can we pray one prayer before we take a few testimonies? Then we'll pray the final prayer. Can you stand in the gap on behalf of your family right now and cast the devil out? Can you rebel against the devil? Can you rebel against the devil? Can you rebel against the devil? Jesus. Now listen carefully. Listen carefully. I see something like a silver padlock. The bondage that is operating in a certain family here was sealed by a padlock. This family that I speak of is under the lock of a padlock. I'm going to pray and destroy that padlock. Wait. And when we do that, the member of such a family that is present here will react. Then through that, we will cast out the devil that is troubling that family. Is that clear? So we'll do just two or three cases like that. Can we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, that family that is bound by a padlock, any member of that family that is present here this afternoon, I ask that you stretch forth your hand so that these people can be delivered. Can you stretch forth your hand, O God, and identify that individual by a touch of the anointing? Bring the lady. Any other one, Lord, implicated by this insight, identify by a touch of the anointing. A touch of the anointing. A touch of the anointing. Now, can you do me a favor? Stretch your hand in a direction and ask God to destroy that padlock right now. Ushers, watch out for reactions. Reactions, reactions, reactions. The padlock bondage, the padlock bondage, the padlock bondage. Watch out for reactions. If there's anyone caught up in this padlock bondage, in this padlock bondage, Lord, identify. Bring him, bring him. Let him go. Let her go. In the name of Jesus. Bring her, bring her, bring her, bring her. Hey, the padlock is breaking. The padlock is breaking. It's breaking already. It's breaking. I release you in the name of Jesus. I release you in the name of Jesus. I release you in Jesus' name. Break! Break! Yes, 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 come out. Come out of that place in the name of Jesus. Can we do another prayer? If you are still with me, say amen. Hey. Okay. These ones are out, so we can commence. Can we still pray for our families? You are standing in the gap, and as you labor, we will locate what is happening and deal with it. We'll do that three times, then I will stop the deliverance session. And we'll do one more thing before. How many are there? Two. No, they are not two. Three people have received healing on their eyes already. There can be more, but cannot be less than two. So I'm waiting for you there. Can we cry, stand in the gap on behalf of our families and cry and tell Satan to leave? Tell him, make sure you are not quiet. 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 In the name of Jesus, I can't hear your amen. Listen, I see a ritual. This ritual involved the digging of a grave. At the end of the ritual, the stem of a banana tree. Do you know that long one? If it is possible for you to stop praying, you will hear me. It might be that you are you praying. It might be that you are the one God wants to deliver. The one God wants to deliver. Somebody is still not hearing. Okay. I'm going to pray. The Lord will arrest that person whose debt has been concluded in our midst. As I pray the prayer, don't say amen again. You have said enough amen for 1 week. So, hold on. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, that individual that came for this conference to seek refuge from you, whose debt has already been concluded, I ask, stretch forth your hand from my left hand side under the canopy in the main congregation among the ministers in the choir. Let the Holy Spirit search. When you find a person, Lord, by a touch of the anointing, reveal them. Search. Whenever you notice the reaction, you bring the people so that we can do the deliverance. You don't come to the house of God to die. The only merchandise we have here is life. Yes. So we command you, come out from the grave. In the name of Jesus, come out. Let the yoke over you break. Let the yoke over you break. 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 Wait. Wait. You shake me. Shake me. Yes, they are coming out now. They are coming out now. Yeah, you can come out now. You can come out. You can come out. So I have authority from the Lord to send the debt back to where they went to look for it. Father, in the name of Jesus, this hunter that has been dispatched, let it go back and haunt the one that sent it. In the name of Jesus. Yeah.
Yes. Aiko Selimahade. Aiko Malamanaya. Aisalokondi. Aiko Sketobrinda Babore. Okay. Now do me a favor. Take your seat. Take your seat. Leave them until the Lord finishes with them. Don't interrupt. Don't interrupt. Don't interrupt them. So we want to make sure that nobody lives here with a yoke. That's what this session is about. That no one lives here carrying the yoke that they brought. I saw an usher so diligent, but they are taking the name somewhere, so we had to remove the name. So we will not take for granted. We'll just ensure that you don't go back with a yoke. Okay? All right. Yes, what happened there?
Okay. This sister, when you said call someone who is not here, who is blind, or who has eye problem. The father who is at home has
the father who is at home, where is home? Can we hear Uyo? Your father is in Uyo. Yes. Yes. What happened to your father?
He can't read without glasses.
He can't read without glasses.
And it's been a concern for me for a while. So I stood in the gap and I placed my hand on my eyes.
Yeah.
So after the prayers, and you said we should confirm, I called him and asked him to pick up a book and read without his glasses.
Take up a book and read in Uyo without his glasses.
And he did.
He started reading.
Yes, sir.
Now, I told you, as a male usher, don't touch, when I'm ministering, don't touch female. Please. You have other duties that you can do. Leave. They covered your face. Father, take, free her. I see the spirit of insanity have been released. It's over a family, but there's a particular member of the family they are targeting. Father, anywhere that person is in this congregation, by a touch of your anointing, identify the person. By a touch, 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 by a touch. You are not supposed to go back with the affliction. You are not supposed to go back with the pain, with the sickness, with the sickness. Usher, usher, come. Let me be sure that you are free. Shake me, shake me. So come out of that place. Come out of that place. Meanwhile, who is Esther now? Who are you calling? What's the problem? Can we pray? Can we pray? No, don't stand up. You will distract yourself. Sit. Wait. Sit down. Avoid distraction like a plague. Avoid it. Okay. You are free now. You know what has happened to you? Things will no longer be difficult to happen. It will be easy now. Okay? You have served the Lord, a woman of God. now things will be fast. All right? So we want to pray for this Esther that this sister is calling. And use the Esther as a point of contact. And bring her out from under the authority of insanity. Can you pray? Is it possible? All right, let's pray for her. We use this lady as a point of contact. Let the spirit of insanity, we withdraw that spirit. We withdraw it. We take it back. Go back from whence you came. Listen quickly. Listen to me. Your family member served the deity before your dad died. He whispered to you that he would have loved you to take over the affairs of the deity, but you have refused. But till this moment, you still hear voices. You are the one? Stretch your hand in the direction of our brother and blot out the window that spirit is. Now bring that lady, bring her. Hey. Drop your hands. It might be that there are many more people. Father, if there are still people that evil spirits are transmitting into their spirits, in this place, stretch forth your hand, and by a touch of the anointing, identify them. Locate them. If there's still anyone left, by a touch of the anointing. Okay. Can we pray for two of them now? Stretch forth your hand now. And we are disconnecting them from that transmission. From today, it will be impossible for the transmission to get across to their spirit. This kind of, if you were the one we were praying for, will you be praying like this? Because it's not you. You are managing the prayer. Make sure you disconnect the transmission. We cut it off. We cut off the transmission. We release you from the field of the transmission. Hey, your wealth that has been scattered, the good things that have been diverted from your life, we stop that illegality. We command the restoration in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for your son
We demand that he be disconnected. He be disconnected. He be disconnected. Hey. Let the things taken from you be restored. Be restored. Be restored. In the name of Jesus. Sister, raise your head. Shh. Let her do it herself. Possible for you to, oh my God, just shake me. Okay, now look at me. Look, look, you will come out. If you look, look, just look, you will come out. Just look, don't remove your eyes. Okay, where is the man taking the testimony? Okay, so. Your dad read without her glasses. Father, we decree that his sight condition is a permanent victory in Jesus' name. Yes, you can go. What happened to the mic?
Praise God. From last week, I've been having eye constraint in my two eyes.
Eye constraints.
Went to teaching hospital, was given some drugs, been using eye drops, so but I can't see clearly. And as I came, I had a body in my heart. I've been listening to your messages, and they are like injections to my soul. So as I sat there, I said, Lord, I need an experience. So while I was sat there, I saw a ministry, what I was dropping from my left eye. So I offered a prayer. I think it assists.
It assists now. Come here. Come. Father, in the name of Jesus, let every eye defect be rolled out. Rolled out. I command your eyes. See. 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 In the name of Jesus. Oh! Thank you. Now, can you do me a favor? Look for bottled water. Give him, let him wash his face and come and tell us what happened. Yeah? What happened there?
Had a boy in my ear. So
I didn't hear that.
I had boy in my ear.
Your ear was blocked?
Yes, when I was small, so I had boy in my ear.
Oh, you had boil?
Yes.
Now if you want us to hear what he's saying, don't put the mouth on it.
I had boy in my ear when I was
okay.
Small.
Leave your head where it is. Just talk.
I had boy in my ear when I was small.
Okay, he had boil in his ear when he was small. It led to the deafening of his left ear.
Yes, instead of making use of only this one.
He'd been making use of only one ear.
But after the prayers, I felt a burning sensation on his
ear. A burning sensation on the ear.
The ear began to move on its own.
Wait.
So when he asked us to check,
yeah.
I closed this ear.
Yeah. And he could hear with the other ear. Yes. Come. He's been healed of a deafening. So now we can celebrate. At least you know. Yeah. The healing is complete. Go. You've not been able to see. Is it short-sightedness, long-sightedness? What is it? Short-sighted.
Uh-huh.
Oh, you broke it by yourself? You got tired? Okay. You couldn't see my face from where you were sitting? You can see my face now. I hope the face is fine. Is it okay? Okay. I want to bless you. There's still one person whose eye was corrected that is in the congregation. Did you check it? Any change?
Can see clearly.
You can see clearly now. Okay. So, it's remaining one eye case. Somebody in the congregation has been healed and the person is still there. So let's take inventory. Hallelujah. Yes, what happened to you?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I've been finding it difficult to read the Bible that I do read. And I recently went so bad I can't access it on my phone. At night, I have to.
To make it bigger. See to the small one and you could see it. Somebody shout hallelujah. Come. Let's confirm that the miracle is complete. Okay, yeah, it's complete. Yes? So you laid your hands on your eyes and there's an improvement. So we name it permanent. In the name of Jesus. Yeah, you're released. Final assignment. Final assignment before I go. Yeah, what happened? Now listen, there's someone that called somebody. You call somebody so that the person can participate in the healing. And I'm seeing that the person has been healed. So please, those of you that call somebody, call again and confirm. Call again. You have to, yes? Go on.
Yes, I used to find it difficult to read.
To read?
Yes, I went.
Glasses, okay.
There is also a page in my Bible that is very tiny. That one, even with the glass, I find it difficult
to read it.
It's just checking for them.
You can read it, okay. Yeah, it's complete. You see, I see a woman that has been healed in her eyes. That's what I'm seeing. I can't remove it. The vision is before my face. So I'm waiting for that woman. This woman uses glasses. God healed the eyes. She's wearing wrapper. Wrapper. The woman I saw had wrapper. So I'm waiting for that woman. I'm waiting for the woman. Now, two of you come. Did you test it?
Yes, sir.
Oh, you tested it? Your own, did you test your own?
Yes, sir.
Why are you crying?
Because I was trying, but I'm sure.
She was trying to be very sure. Now she's sure. Can we celebrate Jesus? We have 15 more minutes, out of which I will use 5. We'll just pray in the Spirit. If there's anything that we have forgotten, the Holy Spirit will bring it back. Okay? Pray in the Spirit. I'll use 5. 5 more minutes. Can we pray in the Spirit for 5 minutes? For 5 minutes. You don't need to stand up. Just stay where you are. Avoid distraction. Avoid distraction. Avoid distraction. Avoid destruction.
Go see the high mode. Lasco Fresley La Handelia. Aila Mahasale. Yeso saliko premo santali. Yeni mokuria braske tobi nanga hize. Yeso salabantali iko mezo zeli. Meli mose kuti alamba kude. Jesus.
There's a woman yesterday night, you had a dream, and this dream was you were captured. You were captured in a place, and then you escaped from where you were captured. And the people that put you into captivity were chasing you, but they did not catch up with you before you woke up. It happened yesterday night. Where is the woman? Yesterday night. Find out from her story.
I had a dream yesterday night.
Yeah.
It was like in a church.
Okay.
And then I saw one of my pastor, a man of God was laying down on him. And then where I was sitting, I just received in my spirit that he was a fake man of God. So I started calling him. I said, stand up from there, stand up from there. Before we knew it, it now turned to like a gathering of witchcraft. He started manipulating and manipulated him.
Another person. The one that can talk. I say, Yes? What happened to you?
Pray.
No. Just go straight. Go straight. See, it's 5 minutes. You want to take time.
Sorry.
The Lord is already praised. Even now, he's praised.
I had a dream. I even told my neighbors I was living here with two of them that in a condition like this, my reverend father called me out because I came here with a sick child. He now told me in that dream, why didn't I bring this child here ever since? And I've been going other places. Now God has healed me. So this morning I woke up, still 2 years.
Kai, you are not sick. Okay, next person. Thank you for your experience.
Yes, last night I was in a dream.
Did I say you should go?
So in that
okay,
dream,
go.
In that
go.
Dream, it was at sea. I traveled home.
You traveled home?
Yeah. So I saw myself. When I got to my house, my gate was locked already. And I checked time, it was 12 in the midnight. So I was like, how am I going to leave this place? And I can't enter the house. And it's late already. Then I saw two men, a man and a woman. The way they appeared was so scary. And they said the only way they can leave me is except I give them money. And there was no money with me. I was just with my daughter. So I told them that there's no money with me. Then I saw myself as I was speaking in tongues. So I don't know how they went. Before I opened my eye, I didn't see them again.
Okay. Yeah? Is your voice back now? Okay. So, let's hear.
Yesterday, I had a dream. I was in an environment I don't know. Then, I was with my family members. It was as if we were all tied down. And I was crying. Then suddenly I saw a hand lift me up. Then I was now dragging them. Well, I couldn't drag them out, but I...
You escaped. Did the people that put you people in captivity, they chase you?
Yeah, but they couldn't...
That they couldn't get you. So you come. It is one of you that I'm looking for, but I don't know who the person is. That's your dream. I didn't understand it too. Okay, go. Phone call. The person you called. Who is the person? What was the condition after the prayer? What happened?
The person is my father.
Yes. Where is he? Where is he now?
Akwa Ibom, Ikotekwene.
Ikotekwene?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
He has had persistent cough for years that defied.
He has had what?
Persistent cough.
Persistent cough?
Yes.
For
years.
For years.
For years. I've defied all medication and prayers.
Okay.
So I called him when you asked us to call the people that were sick. In between the prayers, the phone hung up. So I didn't bother to call back. But when you asked, we should check that there's someone.
Check now, yes.
I called him back. He said that the tightening on his chains has freed him.
The thing has freed.
Now. Yes,
can we give God a... Yeah, it's true. It's permanent. He will not have that coffee again. Okay? Now, woman, go back. It's okay. It's okay now. It's not by force. Is it by force? It's not by force. Is it by force? Go and sit down. The people don't want deliverance. You say, ha. Leave it. The one that concerns me is this. That dream was not what God revealed to me. So I have a choice either to this one God sent me to them. Are you following? Don't create what is not existing. I don't know who you are clapping for. Among these two ladies, God has sent me to one of them. So we'll ask the Lord to show who he's talking about. Father, by a touch of the anointing, I ask, show me the one you are talking about. Show me. Breathe on that one solidly. Breathe. Come and breathe upon that one. In the name of Jesus. Breathe upon that one in the name of Jesus, from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Breathe on her in the name of Jesus. 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 Now I cut you off from that spiritual link. I take you out. Let the oil that you were supposed to carry, originally from the Lord, let it rest on you now. Let it come 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 now. Okay. Father, I cut her off. I cut her off from that place, from that system, from that world. Let the anointing she was supposed to carry originally, let it begin to drop. Let it come. Let it come. Let it come. Let it come. Let it come stronger. Let it come stronger. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. In the name of Jesus, let it come stronger. Let it come. Let it come stronger. Anyone that is kept in a cage, you are released in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Now, watch this. There's somebody, if you do like this, see what I'm doing? It's as if a heavy weight is on your head. Anytime you do like this. Where are you? If you bend like this, it's as if there's a heavy weight on your head. Don't come, just stand. Stand there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The number doesn't matter. It's only one person that I'm talking to. So if you are sure it's you, but the Lord will show me who he's talking about. You can stand even in the overflow. There's one woman there. Father, in the name of Jesus, this one that the weight of Satan, the load of Satan has been placed on, identify by a touch of the anointing, by a touch. Show me. Yeah, don't worry, she's coming out. The covenant is breaking. The covenant, it's a family-based covenant. It's a family-based covenant. It's now that she's coming out. Just give her some time. Oh, so this is the young man that the rest of you can sit down. Bring him. Just allow that lady. Allow her. Hey. You know what? So that... ushers, it's not by force that she will be there. There's enough space. There's space here. Yes, I know she's coming out, but bring her to the theater. Forget about that bead. Just bring her where there's space. Father, in the name of Jesus, we destroy that covenant. We destroy that covenant. We destroy that covenant. We destroy that covenant. We destroy it in the name of Jesus. See, ushers, are you asleep? Okay, raise up. Now, sister, just look at me. Can you look at me? Raise your head. Raise your head. Open your eyes. Look. I will give you that opportunity 3 times. Look. Don't remove your eyes. Just look. Keep looking. Keep looking. Don't close your eyes. Look. Good. Can we do some confessions as I sit down? We are people of prayer, so we should be taught how to use the tongue. Lord? Oh, you're not interested. Don't worry. Maybe. It's okay. You are not interested. Let's try again. Today, I step into the anointing that I was ordained to carry. So that this one is a rehearsal. The next one we'll do is real. When you finish saying it, keep quiet. Don't talk. Then God will begin to anoint people with the anointing they were supposed to carry. Lord,
Today,
I step into the anointing
that I was ordained to carry.
Thank you.
Lift up your hands, begin to bless God. I say, lift up your hands, begin to bless God. Give Him praise for such an awesome invitation. What a blessing. What a blessing. What a blessing. What a blessing.